Hey guys, okay, I'm currently in the bathroom, there's a mirror over there, and I'm gonna show you how I brush my hair. You probably can't tell, but this side I've already brushed with this, it's dried now. But what I normally do is I get this good brush, and I wet it under the tap, give it a little shake, and then I brush my hair. It's really good, it like, makes your hair look a bit longer. Can you tell? Well, it's dried now, so you probably can't. But basically, it makes your hair a bit longer. I suppose just because it's kind of like stretching it a little bit. I do have a hair straightener now, but like, this is just like for school days or whatever. So sometimes if you've got a tangle in your hair, I don't really, but if you've got a tangle in your hair, it's best to brush it from the bottom upwards. Like if you need to wash your hair soon, then brush it from the bottom upwards. I know you might, like if you've seen doll hair tutorial videos, you've seen that there, but like with, say, in particular sensitive hair or something, I don't know, then it actually does help humans as well. Because it's all the same kind of thing, really. I mean, or not, but. and then I've done my parting. I've done my parting. I'm very particular about parting, so. It is very neat indeed, and so what I do, I just get it right at the top there, and just brush it down, right at the top there, brush it down. The reason why I'm brushing this part so much, and why I really do brush it so much, is because I've had a kind of side parting a lot recently, so it's just because that was like, whoop, kind of like, frizzying up and stuff. I do have a bit of frizzy hair here, because that's just what my hair type is like. But other than that, this is a great way to make it a bit straightened if you're just doing it quickly. And really long hair as well, but it still works, I guess. So the next step for those frizzy rizzies up here is this. So it's got a little cap, but it's just, did you see that? I don't know, but God, I'm gonna get this all in my eyes, aren't I? Right, okay. Yeah, if you're a kid like me, you should probably get out help, but Am I even getting it in my hair? I don't even know, I think I did. I have to watch it back if it feels like I did. It's not as like I did. Okay. Oh no, the other hand. Okay, yeah, I definitely got that. Yeah, you should definitely like close your eyes when you do that. I mean, not that it feels slimy or anything, it just feels like maybe like hair gel or something. What am I saying? I've never used hair gel, but whatever. Then I might. I broke it. You might want to just do a quick little spray there, here and there. Just to like make your hair. So, see now my hair actually looks really good. It's better, see? It's a bit blurry, but. Just sprayed some on the top of my hair as well, just to make sure. I might give it one more little brush with the tap. I'll show you how to just. The temperature of the water doesn't really affect
it. You just want to brush your hair out a bit warm.
You probably want to shake your brush before you do that, just in case there's too much water. Then, well, I suppose me and Bella would both do the same thing, but then she would take her scrunchie and do that, so I'm going to give it that.
Hi guys,
little tried to do my parting, so I didn't,
it kind of,
you know, it's better be good.
Better be good.
If you don't know, she's like over there somewhere. I'm sorry. Anyway, cringe. So I normally, what I do, I just take these two parts. And just
the rest of the pot
hold them back and just give my hair a little bit of a brush.
do you need to like fold over your hair?
Yeah, and then I get another piece of hair at the back, you can probably see, and it kind of separates, so that goes over there as if I'm doing a plait, but I'm not. And then I get this bit, just put it over there, it doesn't have to be too neat. It's just then you get like quite a nice effect on the ponytail,
and then brush out the brush.
I didn't use the spray thing on the back of my hair because I forgot to, so I just sprayed it now while I'm brushing my ponytail. And yeah, it doesn't really make a difference apart from, I suppose you should do this with a ponytail anyway. Just get your scrunchie or something. This one is my favourite one recently. And just, this is how I do it. Because being as I have quite long hair now, it's easier, otherwise I'll lose the hairband's place and it will get really messy again. I'm hoping that's not messy. Is that messy? So she's gone. But did you see her leave? Oh no. Because she didn't see me then, so you must have not seen her. Anyway, so I think I've got a little bit of a knot here, so I'm just going to brush that out. A little bit of knots, you just got to kind of like separate that piece of hair a little bit. Yeah, so I'm just separating it. There. And now there's no more knot. And I don't really mind that much if my hairband is showing like that, or like if my hair isn't too neat, but it probably looks nice because I've done that. I'm looking in the mirror right now, and it actually looks pretty good. And then if the hairbrush has got really wet, you might want to give it a little shake over the sink, or like, but you don't have to hang it up with like, I can get maybe hanging up with bristles down, like on a clothes dryer or something, but I normally just like, well, we normally just stick it here and then it just dries, and it's normally not that wet anyway, so it's fine. Bye everyone!